Welcome to ArtBeat. I'm Jeffrey Brown, and joining me today is Christopher Janney. He is a sound artist based in London and Boston. He's here to talk to us about a new installation at Montclair State University. Welcome to you.
Nice to be here.
Now, first describe this. You call this piece, Everywhere is the Best Seat.
Yes. The interesting part of it for me is that that's from a very famous John Cage quote titled, called Everything You Do is Music, and Everywhere is the Best Seat. And that was always his theory about, and if you just open your ears to even what's going on around you, you can hear very beautiful sounds.
Even if you heard nothing, famously,
yes,
right?
Yes, exactly.
Or, well, it wasn't nothing,
exactly.
But it was silence.
Right,
yeah.
Right. So, but what was interesting when Jed Witter, the director of the arts program at Montclair State, asked me to do a piece in this beautiful stone amphitheater that was built during the WPA in the 30s, I thought about it and I said, wait a minute, this is the perfect place to do a piece called Everywhere is the Best Seat, since in this amphitheater it's all seating. So instead of thinking about making a piece that would be on the stage in this amphitheater, I literally made the piece where everybody sits.
And,
so
and it consists of speakers.
Yes.
30-some?
There's a series of 30 columns, and within each column there's a series of lights and audio speakers and photoelectric sensors, so you can actually interact with the piece.
No, and coming out of those speakers are all different kinds of sounds, which individuals trigger themselves?
Yes. Well, out of the 30 speakers comes a score that I've composed, a mix of melodic and environmental sounds. So, and if you can just sit in the amphitheater and the piece will play by itself, like a giant 30-speaker wind chime, as it were. But then you can also step up to one of the speakers and there's a clear handprint, or if you wave your hand in front of it, you will start to hear sound coming out of that individual speaker. But that means that 100 people could stand in here and play this, what I call communal musical instrument, simultaneously, because I still control the melodic and the harmonic parts. So everybody is, all the environmental sounds and the melodic instruments are still singing in harmony. But the rhythmic aspect of it is given over to people playing with the columns.
So what's the, I mean, this combines music, art, architecture, as I know a lot of your work does. What's the idea behind it, of having it both play as something that you control, but also that people can control?
Yeah, well, I think there's a couple of different ideas. One is to do, from an architectural condition, to make some kind of spatial musical environment. So you're not just listening to something in stereo, you're listening to something coming out of 30 speakers all around you. It's an immersive experience. And in that sense, it's a building of sound for me, yes? But then also the interactive part is almost like what I call a social foil.
Social foil?
Yes. It encourages total strangers to interact with one another in this creative place. I've done pieces in subways and in airports. And this thing acts as a structure to allow people to play and interact with one another. And it works very well on a college campus.
A lot of the work that you do is in public spaces.
Part of my interest, you know, is to make art a part of your everyday life. You know, I think that so many of us sort of have the idea that art is in the theater, or it's the concert hall, it's in the museum. So we're going to step away from our life to have this artistic experience. But I really am of the school that art should be a part of your everyday existence. So I try to make work that you would encounter on your way to work, whether it's in airports or subway stops or on the university campus. The piece runs 24 hours a day. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I have students, because we have a video camera, we can see what's going on, but there's students in there at 2, 3, 4 o'clock in the morning. And that's really also important to me, that, you know, art shouldn't happen at an appointed hour. You should be able to go and have an artistic experience when you're ready to have it.
I read you were trained as an architect.
That's right, at Princeton, yeah. So, but, you know, from...
But you're a jazz drummer
From an early age, yeah. From my 12, 13, I was always playing music and drawing, but always drawing sort of mechanical things. Mm-hmm. So there was always sort of this curse, really, of not being able to sort of decide one or the other. Mm-hmm. But when I was in college, I chose the path to go to architecture school. But after that, living in New York, this again, it all sort of opened up again. So I've always sort of had these two disciplines, and instead of trying to fight them, I just said, let's just go right down the middle and see if we can make something, make a career out of something that involves both of them.
I read about one project, and it interests me because I spent a day with Mikhail Baryshnikov once. Yeah, yeah. You did something with him where he's dancing to
the sound of his heartbeat.
Heartbeat.
Because, yeah. You know, if you think of my work as some combination of architecture and music, and sometimes I'm trying to make architecture like music, like the Montclair piece, where I'm taking an architectural site, but putting music and sound into it, making it more spontaneous, more alive. And other times I'm trying to make music more like architecture. And the piece with Misha, called Heartbeat, was a good example of that, where I literally had him wear a wireless telemetry device. So you heard the sound of his heartbeat. And that, in a sense, was the drummer that he danced to in this performance.
What's next? What are you working on now?
The piece Heartbeat. The American Heart Association had asked me a couple of years ago to make a new version. Misha wasn't performing anymore. I got Emily Coates from the New York City Ballet, but then I got the Persuasions, the five a cappella singers, mm-hmm. to actually come, and I wrote a piece of music and had them sing over her heartbeat as she danced. We shot a movie of that, and we're about to premiere it this in October at Montclair State.
All right. Well, the current exhibition is called Everywhere is the Best Seat at Montclair State University. Christopher Janney, nice to talk to you.
Nice to be here.